Welcome to all of you.
欢迎大家的到来。
Let's chant Hare Krishna. Good idea?
Good idea.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Namo Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale, Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane. Namaste Saraswati Deve, Gauravani Pacharini Narisesa, Sunyavadi Paschati Dasatarine. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasudevi Gaura Bhakti Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, oh, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, oh, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama Rama Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna Maha Mantra Ki Jai. Gaur Prema. Hare Hare. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Parishtaya Bhutale Sri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Shamini Tinamane. Namaste Sharashati Deve Gauravani Pacharine Nivise Sasanivare Paschati Desatanine Banchakapa Turubyascha Kripa Shindubyevacha Potitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Krishna Chaitana Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasari Gaura Bhaktivrinda Mukam karati vachalam pangulangayate girim yakripa tamaham bande yakripa tamaham bande siguru dinatarinam. So tonight's topic is, I believe it's self-envy, is that correct?
Yes. I sing a song.
Yes, Leela Rani, that's correct?
Yes, yes, self-envy.
Self-envy. So, I may ask you to tell me something you've read from my book on the chapter on self-envy. Can anybody remember anything they read?
就是今天呢，我们来谈论有关自我嫉妒的这个主题。大家就是在我的书里有没有读到过有关相关的内容？你们可以分享一下吗？
我读到就是如果我们在物质上或者灵性上做对自己不利的事情，这就是自我嫉妒的一种表现。So
if we do something harmful. For ourselves, so this is the symptoms of self-envy.
Yes. Anything else you remember?
还有其他的吗?
Women 做对别人不好的事情也是一种自我嫉妒。
If we do something bad to others, it's also self-envy.
Because it hurts ourselves. We hurt ourselves when we hurt others.
Yeah. Yes. 因为他也同样会伤害我们自己，也会伤害他人。
What else?
If we don't do something we could do, and we blame our failure to others.
Oh, we blame others for our failure.
Yeah. 就是说，我们本来是可以去做某些我们能够做到的事情，但是呢，我们却没有采取行动，那么我们却把自己的这种失败归咎于他人。
Because we don't improve ourselves. So basically, whenever we don't improve ourselves, it can be it can be called self-envy.
事实上呢，就是当我们没有做出自我改善的时候呢，这种情况就被称为是自我嫉妒。Anything
else you remember?
还有其他的事情吗？ 其他的要点这些知道。If you don't try to understand Krishna, you are commit suicide. This is self-envy because you don't try to understand the soul and relationship with Krishna.
Yeah, spiritual suicide. You're killing your opportunity to advance spiritually.
Yeah. 那么还有就是，如果你不去努力的了解 Krishna， 那么你就是在做灵性的自杀。因为你不理解自己的真实身份，没有让自己能够获得灵性进步的机会。
So all these ideas are very similar.
所以呢，所有的这些要点呢，它都是类似的。
Like, we have one definition of violence.Whereas if I prevent somebody from making spiritual advancement, or I could help them make spiritual advancement and I don't, then I'm said to be committing violence to them.
那么呢，我们对这个暴力呢有一种定义，就是如果我阻碍了他人的这种灵性进步，或者是呢本来我可以帮助他人取得灵性进步，但是我却没有去这样去做，那么这就
Like if I have children and I don't raise them to be devotees, at least I don't try, then I'm actually committing violence to my children.
就比如说如果我有孩子，我没有努力的想要把他们培养成奉献者，或者说我没有这样去尝试，那么呢我其实是就是在对他们进行施暴。
So obviously it means,Spiritually, we would be killing someone spiritually if we don't help them.
现在如果我们就是没有帮助他人的话呢，我们取得灵性进步呢，那么我们就是在这个灵性上，就是在杀害他们。
Prabhupada talks about that in the Bhagavad Gita.So, if we use that definition of violence, where we're preventing someone or preventing someone from making spiritual advancement, means we're harming them.
是如果我们就是阻碍了他人取得这个灵性进步，从这种情况来说呢，我们就是在伤害他人。
Then the opposite of that would mean that if we're helping them make spiritual advancement, then we're doing the highest, we're giving them the highest welfare, or you could say even the highest form of love.
就是相反的呢，就是如果我们帮助他人取得灵性进步，我们就是在对别人，就是给予这个最崇高的慈善事业，或者是给予他人最高的爱。
So now, if that's true in our dealings with other people, then it's also true in our dealings with ourselves.
所以呢，如果这个原则呢，在我们与他人相处的时候是适用的，那么它同时也适用于我们自己。
And that's why Prabhupada sometimes uses the word spiritual suicide.
所以呢，这就是为什么帕巴的有时候他会用这样的词，就是灵性的自杀。
Like if you have the opportunity to become Krishna conscious and you just say, I don't want it, I totally give it up. Prabhupada would call that spiritual suicide. You just killed your opportunity, your spiritual opportunity to become Krishna conscious.
就比如说你本来是有机会可以变得具有 Krishna 知觉的，但是呢你并不想，于是呢你就放弃了。那么怕怕的就是说，事实上你就就是抹杀了你可以变得具有 Krishna 知觉的这种灵性的机会。
Now, does that make sense?
对你们大家听起来有道理吗？
If you think what would be violent to another person, if you treat yourself that way, it's also violence to yourself.
就是如果从你自己来看，你对待他人的这种方式可以被称为是暴力的话，那么你以同样的方式对待自己，那么这就是一种，也是一种暴力。So,
when Prabhupada uses the word self-envy, he actually means self-hatred.
那么呢，当帕巴达用这个自我嫉妒这个词的时候，他真正意义上是指自我憎恨。
And in Bhagavatam, there is a word self-deceit, self-deception.
然后呢，就是在《博伽梵歌》中有这么一个词，就是自我欺骗。And
self-deception means the same thing. You know what you should do, but you do something. You know what you should do that's good for you, but you do something that's bad for you. So that deception ends up harming yourself. So self-deception becomes self-harm or self-hatred, and self-envy becomes self-harm, self-hatred.
所以呢，就是他的这个意思呢，就是说你本来知道你应该去做一些自己有利的事情，就是对自己比较有益的，但是呢，你却做了伤害自己的不好的一些事情。 那么呢，这就被称为是自我伤害或者自我嫉妒、自我仇恨。So,
Prabhupada gave an example, and I think I gave this example in the book.
帕巴达就给我们举了一个例子，我想我在书中也提到了这一点。If
a man goes to a secluded place and kills himself, then you know nobody can help him.
如果一个人他到隐秘的地方自杀了，然后呢，其他没有人可以帮助他。So
he's comparing that to being that you're given spiritual knowledge and you know what to do, but instead of taking that knowledge, you set it aside and you engage in material life. He said that's spiritual suicide and that's self-envy.
那么呢，就是像这种情况呢，就被比喻成，就是你已经被赐予了这个灵性的知识，但是呢，你却没有恰当的去利用，你把它搁置起来，你仍然去追求那些物质的事物，那么呢，这就被称为是自我。 自杀或者是自我嫉妒。
Sometimes someone will tell us that what we're doing is bad for us and we'll say, I know, but I don't care.
有时候呢，有些人可能会明确的给我们指出来，你目前在做的事情事实上会伤害你，但是呢，我们却回答说，我不在乎。
Children do that a lot.
通常的话，孩子会经常犯这样的问题。Don't
eat this; it's not good for you. I don't care.
你别吃这个，对你的身体不好，我才不在乎呢。But
the problem is, sometimes we do that also.
这问题就是有时候我们也会犯类似的错误。And
it's really important that we become aware of the tendency to do that because it can be very destructive.
很重要的一点，我们需要去自觉到，就是我们有这样的行为，因为这个行为对我们来说是非常具有破坏力的。Because
that's another way of saying, I don't care about myself. This is bad for you. I don't care if it's bad for me. I'm going to do it. I don't care about myself. That's what we're
saying. 因为呢，就是这是我们。 就是不能进行自我关爱的一种表现。那么呢，别人已经跟你说了，你做这件事情，就是很糟糕，会伤害到你。然后呢，你就很满不在乎的说，我才不在乎呢。Now,
if you examine Prabhupada's instructions from this perspective, it's easy to understand that underneath those instructions, there's a message, you should care about these instructions. This is good for you. You should do this. Yes?
Yes. 那么呢, 就是, 如果你要是去分析帕巴德的这些训示的话呢, 你会发现在他训示的下面呢, 包含着他的这种申请, 就是希望我们能够遵守他的训示, 去做我们对自己有益的这个事情, 不要去做伤害我们的这个事情。
Chant your rounds, follow these principles. This is good for you. You should do it.
你呢去念诵你的圈数, 遵守事项规范原则, 这对你是非常有助的。
Vrinda Devi, chant your rounds, follow the principles. It's good for you. You should do it.
Vrinda Devi, 你需要念诵。 念好你的圈数，遵守事项规范原则，这对你来说是非常有帮助的。
And then I say, you should care about your spiritual life. You should care about it.
然后我会说，你应当关心你自己的灵性生活。
You should take care of your spiritual life.
你也应当照顾好你的灵性的生活。
You should give yourself sufficient time to chant, to read, and care for yourself spiritually.
你应当给你自己足够的时间去念诵阅读，然后呢，在灵性上去关心自己。
So really, with any instruction Prabhupada gives, the unstated instruction is, this is good for you, you should care about yourself, and you should do this. Isn't it?
Yes.
See? Yes.
那么就是在帕巴的给的他的这个训示的背后呢, 事实上是包含着这样的一层深意，就是这些训示都是对你有好处的，你应当就是关心你自己，你应当按照这个训示去做。So
this little voice that sometimes says, I don't care, is destructive.
所以呢，有时候我们就会内心中有这么一个小声音，就告诉我们说，我才不在乎呢。
And if you ever hear that voice,
你们大家有没有就是听到过自己内心的这种小声音?
When the voice says, I don't care, you should say back, but you should care.
就是当你内在有个声音对你说我才不在乎的，你应该就是回击他一下，你说我应当在乎。
Prabhupada wants you to care. It's not wrong to care. It's wrong not to care.
帕巴的想让你能够在乎，就是呢，你在乎你自己，这并不错。你不在乎才是不对的。
I have noticed that in general, devotees who have good sadhana every day are really of the mindset that I need to care for my spiritual life. That mindset is very strong, and that's why they have good sadhana every day.
那么呢，就是我注意到，就是那些每天都进行好的sadhana的这个奉献者呢，就是他们的这个心意的一个模式呢，就是他们特别在乎他们的这个sadhana，所以呢，他们就每天都有特别好的这个sadhana。
I don't know if you've ever thought like this, but there's this thought, well, if I get up early and I chant, it's very selfish. It's just for me.
然后呢，我不知道你们大家有没有注意到这一点。有时候呢，我们就是早起，我们念诵的话呢，有时候可能是比较自私的。
Or I want to read Prabhupada's books. It seems like I'm being very selfish.
就是呢，我早上起来就是我阅读帕巴的书籍，就是看起来好像就是只是为自己考虑，有点自私。That
selfishness is required.
但是呢，这种自私是需要的。That
selfishness is good.
而且这种自私也是对我们有益的。
Because we need to care about ourselves. Prabhupada wants us to care about ourselves. So if there's any mentality of I don't care, then we answer back, but you should care.
所以呢,任何时候如果我们听到了这种小声音,我才不在乎呢,我们应当回击他,说我在乎。
Why should I care? Because Prabhupada wants me to care.
我为什么需要在乎呢? 因为帕巴的希望我能够在乎。
And aside from that, I should be compassionate upon myself and give myself Krishna consciousness, just like I give everyone else Krishna consciousness.
而且呢,除此之外,我应当对自己怜悯,自我怜悯,给予我自己Krishna知觉,就像我给予他人Krishna知觉一样。
Now, anyone who is a book distributor or has been for many years spreading Krishna consciousness knows they can't be effective doing that if they don't give themselves enough time for their sadhana.
就是呢,那些已经花了多年的时间进行派书传播 Krishna 知觉的奉献者,他们会意识到,如果他们没有好的 sadhana 的话呢,他们的派书不可能富有成效。
So let's say you see Nadia eating breakfast. And you say, Nadia, you're so selfish. Why are you eating breakfast? You should be out on the street distributing Prabhupada's books.
就比如说, Nadia, 她在吃早餐,你可能会说, Nadia, 你是如此的自私,为什么还要吃早餐呢? 为什么不直接出去去派书呢?
And Nadia says, but if I don't eat, I won't have energy to distribute books. So my eating is not selfish, it's just so I can have the energy to distribute books. So it's the same with chanting japa. Nadia, why are you chanting your rounds? You should be out on the street distributing books, because if I don't chant my rounds, I won't have the potency to distribute the books. So self-care and service, it's the same thing. It's just different sides of the same coin.
所以呢,就是,Nadia,你为什么要念诵你的劝书啊?您呢,出去派书啊?那么如果我要是不念诵我的劝书的话,我就没有足够的能量去派书。所以呢,就是, 这个自我关爱和这个服务，事实上他们是就如一个硬币的两面一样。Now
sometimes there's a mentality that, well, Krishna doesn't care if I'm Krishna conscious or not. So why should I care if he doesn't care?
然后呢，我们就想，那不管我有没有 Krishna 知觉，Krishna 可不在乎。既然 Krishna 都不在乎，为什么我还要在乎呢？
You ever think like that, any of you?
你们大家有没有过这种想法?
He doesn't care, why should I?
就Krishna都不在乎我,我为什么还要在乎自己呢?
Okay, that makes sense. But if he does care, then it would make sense you should care also, right?
那么呢,如果你的这个逻辑成立的话, 那么就是相反的,如果Krishna真的在乎的话,你自己也应该在乎,对不对?
So, Krishna came down here, spoke Bhagavad Gita, to get us, and then we're still here, we didn't really listen. So Mahaprabhu came down to get us with a little more powerful message. So he's after us, he wants us. It should be obvious to all of us that he wants us.
那么呢,就是Krishna亲自降临于世,讲述国家梵歌,事实上他就是让我们能够去自我,就是关心自己,在乎我们,但是呢,我们可能并不那么在乎,然后呢,现在Mahatma Prabhu 前来帮助我们，他在我们后面一直就是盯着我们，然后呢，让我们能够就是在乎自己。
So, even if let's say I don't even care if I go back to Godhead, but Krishna cares, and so for him I should care because he cares, I should care.
就比如说，我能不能回归家园，我不在乎。但是呢，如果 Krishna 在乎你，想让你回归家园的话，那么你也应该去在乎这件事情。
Then another mentality could be something like, I don't deserve it.
还有另外一个心态就是，我不配的。
And it's true, we don't deserve it.
是的，我们每个人都不配的。
But if Krishna wants to give it, and he wants us to take it, it doesn't matter if we deserve it or not, because he wants us to take it. So it's not even an issue whether we deserve it or not.
所以呢，就是如果 Krishna 赐予我们，并且想让我们来接受这份礼物的话，那么我们自己就是有没有资格配不配的不重要，重要的就是我们去接受，去在意 Krishna 所在意的。
Now some of us in growing up may have developed a habit of neglecting ourselves or neglecting our own needs.And then that can carry over to neglecting our spiritual needs. It's the same mentality.
有些人呢，在他们的成长过程当中呢，他们就是有一种自我忽略的倾向，他们会很容易忽略自己的需求。那么这一点心态呢，也同样有时候会发生在他们的灵性生活当中，他们会忽略自己的灵性的需求。
So,If you have that mentality, that's something you have to work on.
所以呢，如果你有这样的一个心态的话呢，那么你就需要做出努力去改善它。
Like, maybe you grew up and whenever you had some need, people would say, "Who cares? Who cares about your needs? We don't care."
就比如说在你的成长过程当中，有可能你会有这样的经历，就是你的需求呢，就是别人会对你说谁在乎你的需求呢？我们根本就不关心。
You know, it happens sometimes with kids, you know. The parents, they don't make the kids feel important. Or you have two siblings and then younger one gets all the attention, the older one is felt like I'm not important. So some people grow up with that, feeling that they're not valuable.
就有时候呢，这个孩子就会有这种感觉，他觉得就是对于父母来说他并不那么重要。尤其是当有两个孩子的话呢，就是可能其中一个感觉的受到了这个忽略，他自己没有这种价值感。
So that mentality, if it carries over into bhakti, then we may not take our sadhana seriously because we are used to being neglected, and so we just learn to neglect our own needs.
那么呢，就是如果这个心态它被带入到这个妨碍当中的话呢，那么我们就倾向于去忽略我们的这个sadhana， 因为我们过去已经习惯了去忽略我们这种需求，那么也会就是忽略这种灵性的这个需求。
So we mentioned that self-envy means self-hatred, and then therefore the opposite will mean self-love.
那么呢，我们提到了这个自我嫉妒呢，其实它也就意味着自我憎恨。它的反面呢，就是自我关爱，爱自己。
And self-love sounds very selfish, doesn't it? Like, oh, you're so bad, you love yourself. You're narcissistic. It sounds bad.
就是呢，这个自我关爱，爱自己，听起来好像是比较自私， 就是你已经那么糟糕了，你还爱自己啊？
But we're talking about love of the soul.
我们现在谈论的是爱我们的灵魂。
And so Prabhupada said, because we're part of Krishna, love of the soul, love of that self, is none different from love of Krishna. They're together. They're the same thing.
帕巴德曾经说过，因为我们是灵魂，我们就是爱Krishna，就是我们爱自己和爱Krishna其实都是一致的。 Yes.
So, I just want to impress upon you that any form of spiritual self-neglect is really like you could call it self-abuse.
所以呢，我只是想让你们有一个深刻的印象，就是任何你们忽略自己的这个灵性方面呢，就可以被称为是这个自我虐待。
And if you have that tendency to be a little bit self-abusive, you have to practice doing things which are self-nurturing and develop a new habit.
所以呢，就是如果你们有这个自我虐待的这个倾向的话呢，你们应当就是转变培养起就是这种自我滋养的一些新的习惯。
And that spiritual selfishness is never selfish. It's never sense gratification. It's never going to have a bad effect on you.
就是呢，这个自我滋养呢，它就是永远不会是一件就是不好的事情，它永远会对你有益。So
if anything is blocking you from being more self-compassionate, then hopefully this class will help you get through that or understand that you need to get through it and give you some insight how to get through it.
那么呢，就是如果你目前呢，就有一些东西阻碍了你进行自我怜悯，爱自己的话呢，那么这堂课呢，就会给到你一些视角。 就让你能够突破这一点，能够实现这种自我关爱。It
actually helps to love yourself as a soul. That helps your sadhana.
所以呢，就是如果你把自己作为灵魂去爱的话呢，这一点也会有助于你的sadhana。Why
do I try to get up early? Why do I try to chant my rounds well? Why do I make time to read Prabhupada's books? It's really because I love myself as a soul and I want to go back to Godhead. That's why I do those things.
就是呢，我为什么要早起，念诵好我的圈数，然后呢，花时间阅读帕巴的书籍呢？因为我爱我自己的灵魂，我想要回归守神。
So I think I can stop now. That's all I want to say tonight.
And then
let you ask questions. No.
有关这个话题呢，我就讲那么多。我们看一下有没有什么问题。
This is the fourth program I've had today. I think my mind just kind of wore out. But I think that's the main point of the chapter, I believe.
所以呢，这是我想要传达的一个主要的一个观点。大家有问题都可以提上来哦。然后我们看一下这个文言，感悟。在我了解了什么是嫉妒时，感觉我随时都有可能陷入嫉妒中，把自己的一切断送在这嫉妒，这是一件可怕的事情。
When I understand what is envy, I feel that at any moment I may fall into envy, and I may destroy myself because of envy. So this is a very horrible thing.
Yeah. It's probably because you develop that mentality at some point in your life. You developed it, or people convinced you were bad and you learned to like hate yourself or not, or something like that. I mean, who's asking this question?
Wen Yan.
So ask her if that makes sense, or to her.
就是呢，或者说，你之所以会有这种心态呢，有可能是在你的过往的经历当中呢，就是有人让你确信，就是你自己是很糟糕的，因此呢，你就会憎恨你自己，就是不知道我所提到的这一点，对你来说是不是恰当的？
有没有这种？At some point in your life, you may have been told or made to believe that you're not really valuable, and taking care of yourself is like wrong, and that's why it's difficult, and that's why it makes it difficult for you.
就是呢，可能在你的经历当中呢，有人曾经告诉过你，你并没有什么价值，然后呢，就是你照顾好自己的话呢，这是不恰当的，所以呢，就是对你来说可能会有一些困难。
That self that you're envious of, that's the self Krishna wants. So you see, it's a contradiction. Krishna wants to love that self, and you won't let him love it because you don't like the self that he wants to love. Does that make sense, Jamuna?
Yes. 就是Krishna就是想要你自己爱自己，但是呢，就是你目前的话呢，没法去爱自己，那么呢，就是这中间就是有这种冲突矛盾，那么这是一种自我嫉妒。And
like we can't believe that Krishna would want to love us, isn't it? That's hard to believe, isn't it?
就好像 就是Krishna爱我们，但是呢，对我们来说，似乎看起来我们很难相信Krishna是爱着我们的。I
thought Krishna doesn't like Chinese people.
我们可能以为，我认为Krishna并不爱我们中国人。I
thought Krishna doesn't like Russians. I thought he doesn't like women. No, he likes women, we know that.
我以为就是Krishna他不爱俄罗斯人，Krishna他不爱女人。事实上Krishna他是爱的。You
know, we have 78% of the qualities of Krishna. You know that? 78%.
你们大家知道吗? 我们就是可以拥有Krishna品质的78%的Krishna的品质。
I just want to congratulate you for that. You have 78% of Krishna's qualities. That's amazing.
我想就是为你们大家所有人来祝贺这一点，就是你们可以拥有Krishna品质的78%。
That's the part of you that Krishna loves.
就是呢，这一点呢是属于，这是属于Krishna爱的一部分。
So just let him love that.
所以呢，就是，that's
the part of us that Krishna loves is the soul with the 78% of his divine quality. So we should just let him love that.
那么这也是Krishna爱我们的这个原因，因为我们具有Krishna这个品质的78%，我们是灵魂，所以Krishna他是爱着我们的。
So at least we should understand that that programming we got, if we got it to feel like however you're feeling that's getting in the way, that it's just Krishna doesn't see it that way.
那么呢，我就是想让你们能够就是注意到，就是这可能是你的原来的一些模式，那么呢就是你会有这样的感受，就是阻碍了你去看到，就是阻碍了你去爱自己。那么呢，Krishna他并不是这样看待的，就是。
So, if Krishna gives you a let's say Krishna gave you a present.
就比如说 Krishna 送你一件礼物,
and you kind of hate yourself.
然后呢, 你想要去就是憎恨你自己。
So what do you tell Krishna?
那么呢, 你会对 Krishna说什么呢?
He said, I don't deserve it, take it back. Give it to somebody else.
你可能会说, Oh, Krishna, 我不配得这个礼物。
And he says, no, I want to give it to you. I love you. And then you're looking around. Who's he talking to? Couldn't be talking to me.
然后呢,你就看着他说, Oh, 那么就是Krishna, Krishna说不,因为我爱你,所以呢,想要送你这个礼物。 但是呢,你当时就想, 那Krishna在给我说话吗？我不相信他在是对我说的。
Could you imagine you went to a birthday party and you gave your best friend a present and they gave it back to you and said, I hate myself, I can't take this. How would you feel?
你可以想象吗？就是想象这个场景，就是你去参加庆祝你朋友的生日，你给他送了一个礼物，然后呢，他却说，我觉得我不配得这个礼物。
You can feel you don't deserve Krishna's love and his mercy, but if he's giving it to you, then you have to say, I don't deserve it, but thank you so much for this gift. I will cherish it. That's how you accept a gift, right?
所以呢，就是，尽管我们可能觉得自己不配得得到 Krishna给的这个礼物。 但是呢，因为是Krishna愿意给我们，所以呢，我们就非常欣喜的接受它。我们呢，就是带着欢欣的一种心情去感谢 Krishna.
If you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, you'll find that Mahaprabhu was giving his mercy to everybody, even the people who were hiding from the mercy. He would find them and give the mercy.
如果你们阅读 Chaitanya Charitamrita 经的话呢，你们会发现。
So it's like you might say, who am I? Who am I to get this mercy? And I would say, who are you not to take the mercy? You understand that? Who am I?
Yeah. 然后呢，我们可能会说，我是谁呀？居然可以获得这种仁慈。然后呢，那么我会反问你，你到底是谁？你居然敢不接受这份仁慈？
Okay, so I just want to let you know it's okay to take the mercy, no matter who you are and what you've done.
所以呢，我就想让你们知道，就是不管你们是谁，不管你们曾经做过怎样的事情，就是你们应当接受这份仁慈。It's
okay to be happy while you take the mercy.
就是呢，当你们接受这份仁慈的话呢。
It's okay to spiritually love yourself.
就是呢，在灵性上爱你们自己，这一点是不应当受到什么指责的。
And it's not okay to do anything that is harmful for your spiritual life.
就是呢，如果你们去做那些伤害你们灵性生活的事情的话呢，这一点可不好。
You agree? Raise your hand if you agree.
Yes. 如果大家同意的话，请举手。
If you don't agree, ask a question.
如果你们不同意的话，请继续问问题。
We have some hands going up.
我看到有一些人举手了。
So if you don't agree, you can ask your question.
所以如果你们不同意的话，就可以继续提问。Okay, so that's the question. Pan Li Feng, Hare Krishna.
We have some devotees who raised their hands. Maybe we should start with them first of all.
They raised their hand to answer the question, not to ask a question.
Ah, all right, I'm sorry. But may I ask you a question then before we go to other questions, please? All right.
Okay, ask.
Thank you, because it's related to the topic. So yesterday I was thinking about it all day and I got really depressed.So in every single class you tell us that Krishna loves you, Krishna loves you, Krishna loves you.And you say that here is the proof and here is the proof and why don't you understand that? But can you please give us one single verse from the Shastra where Krishna says, I love, because he doesn't say it anywhere. He
says,
okay, I just watch, I just look at them. And then if they follow me, they go back to me. And if they don't follow me, then I will send them to hell to burn forever. That's there in Bhagavad Gita. That's right there. It's not love.
That's in your Bhagavad Gita, not in mine.
But no, there is the verse when he says that these people who are demons, I just let them burn forever in hell. And...things like that. So can you please give us one single verse when Krishna says, I love? Because I don't find it anywhere. I just hear it from you, but I don't see when Krishna says it. That's my question.
I'm looking for my body.
Krishna爱着我们，那么你能不能就是举这个经典中的这些话语，这个一个思节，因为我们都是从你这儿得到这个证明的，就是你在一直向我们证明就是 Krishna 爱你们，你们应当理解到这一点但是呢，我昨天就是我在博家梵歌中就是一直在找这样的思节。但是呢，我却没有看到，就是有任何一个师节当中写到 Krishna， 就是爱我们。那么呢，就是，通常我看到的这个师节呢，都是 Krishna 说，你如果遵守我的这些训示，你将回归守神；如果你不遵守的话呢，有可能你就会下地狱。好，故事说，
没有。
然后如果。就是对于那些恶魔，我会把他们置于这个地狱般的这个境地，然后呢，我姑姑说，那这是你的博家梵歌，不是我们的博家梵歌，那么他说，你能不能帮我找一个师姐，就明确的，Krishna 说到他爱我们。
There's I'm going to read the verses for you in a minute.
我呢就是。一会儿将会为你来
So let's say I buy Nadia a new car.
就比如说我给 Nadia 买了一辆车。
And then I buy her a house.
然后呢我也给她买了一栋房子。
And then I buy her a ticket to come to America.
然后呢我也给她买了一个来美国的机票。
And I also buy her a house in America.
我也为她在美国买了一栋房子。
And she says, I'm not really convinced you love me because you never said you did. And what do I say? What do I say? I said it through all those things I did.
然后呢，那迪亚可能会跟我说，我并不相信你是爱我的，因为你从来没有嘴上说你爱我，但是呢，我可以回复他，就是，我已经在做我想说的话。Poor
Krishna.
Poor
Krishna. He's getting a hard time now.
I'm
giving him a hard time, Nadia.
Nadia, 就是你在给 Krishna 一段非常艰难的一段时间。
Do this and you'll come back to Godhead, Krishna's saying, right?
对,他爸说,那个 Krishna 在Bhajavan跟他说,你这样做你会回归我。
But do you really want me to come back to Godhead? I mean, do you? Did we lose Jamuna?
Hare Krishna.
Yeah. So
yeah, I'm here.
Krishna says, I want you to come back to Godhead. And we say, really? Are you sure you want me?
Krishna said, 他想让我们回归 家园，然后呢，我们就会质疑到，Krishna真的想让我们回去吗？
After all, you never even told me you like me.
毕竟你从来没有亲自告诉我，说你喜欢我，你爱我。
So, you know, you're asking me to go back to Godhead and you don't even tell me you like me. I don't know. I don't know if I should go.
你让我回去家园，但是呢，你从来没有直接告诉我说你爱我，所以
So, now we have a comment here. I'll read your comment later. Text 63, chapter 18, and 64.
Chapter 18. Text 63
and 64.
Okay. 18章63-64节
Okay, so in text 64, in text 63, excuse me, 63, Krishna says, I've explained everything. There's nothing more to say.
在4节63, Krishna说了, 就是我已经向你解说一切了,就没有再任何更多的要说的了。
The ball is in your court. Do what you want to do.
就是呢，这个令牌在你手上，你去做你想做的事情。It's
over in text 63.
然后呢，就是在这个63四节中，Krishna他就
And then what happens in the next verse?
那么下一个世界谈到了什么呢?
Krishna keeps speaking.
Krishna 继续说道,
Why?
为什么呢?
Because he doesn't want Arjuna to do whatever he wants. He wants him to follow him. And that's why he's speaking.
因为他并不想让阿尔朱娜随心所欲的，就是按照他自己的想法去做。事实上，他想让阿尔朱娜遵守他的训示，因为这是为了他的益处。Because
you are my very dear friend, I am speaking to you my supreme instruction.
因为你是我非常亲近的朋友，我才向你讲述我至高无上的教诲。Hear
this from me, for it is for your benefit.
就是最为机密的知识，好好聆听，这是为了你的益处。In
the words of my god brother, who has been teaching Bhagavad Gita for 25 years to students and written his own Bhagavad Gita, this is the verse where Krishna says, I love you so much, I want you to come back to me. That is his, knowing Sanskrit, that is his explanation of this verse.
我的一位神兄弟，他教授博伽梵歌已经25年的时间了。然后呢，当他在讲解说这个师节的时候，他当时就明确的说到，这个师节事实上，Krishna就在明确的告诉我们，我爱你们，希望你们能够回归家园。你们如果是这样做的话，你们一定能够回到我的身边。
The Gita is finished. Do what you want to do. And then Krishna tells him what to do. He doesn't want him to do what he wants to do. He wants him to follow him because he loves him so much.
所以呢，就是事实上，Krishna并不想让我们就是随心所欲的去做我们想做的任何事情。Krishna希望我们去遵守他的训示去做。
The next verse, 65, it ends, because you are my very dear friend.
下一章65师节就是说到因为你是我非常亲密的朋友。
1864, that's the verse where Krishna says, I love you.
就是在师节，就是64师节，就是这个师节，就是Krishna事实上明确向我们表明他爱我们。
The other things you said are for the people who don't, they're not devotees. That's how he teaches them.
就是呢，如果有人他还不是奉献者的话呢，这就是我们所教导给他们的。
It is love, because by suffering, they come back to him.
事实上，这才是爱，就是他们通过遭受痛苦，后来他们才。Well, Nadia,
when you go back to Godhead, you can discuss it with Krishna, and you can argue with him.
就是Nadia，当你回到Krishna身边的时候呢，你就可以跟Krishna争辩。
Even in the Bhagavatam, it says sometimes a pure devotee neglects people because it's the best thing for them.
在圣典博伽瓦坛当中呢，有时候呢，就是写到这些圣人有时候会忽略他们，因为这是对他们最好的事情。Sometimes
neglect is the only medicine.
因为你忽略，有时候它是一种最好的一种药物。
However, Krishna interacts with anyone is for their benefit and to bring them back to Godhead. It just may be indirect because they're not ready. And he has to prepare them.
就是事实上, Krishna 无论对一个人做什么都是为了他的最高益处。 有时候可能这个人他还没有做好准备。But
forget those other people. Krishna is telling us, I love you. Because I'm giving you these instructions for you. So that's what we're concerned with.
就是呢，Krishna事实上他说，我爱你，然后呢，我给你这样的训示，以便你能够，就是回到我身边。There's
another way to look at this. That bhakti means to satisfy Krishna.
还有一种就是看待这个事情的方式，就是 bhakti 就意味着去满足 Krishna.
So if Krishna says, "I want this," then we say, "Okay."
Krishna 说他想要这个，然后我们说那好吧。
So if Krishna says, "I want you to go back to Godhead," we say, "Okay, that's what I'm going to do."
然后呢， Krishna 想让我们回归家园，我们就说好吧。
He doesn't want us to share this knowledge with people who don't believe because God gives them independence. But Mahaprabhu, coming as Radharani, shared it with everybody.
就是呢，Krishna呢，他就在博伽梵歌中跟我们说，你不要去跟那些不相信我的人去分享这门知识。 但是呢，主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu却以Radharani的心态显现，然后呢，让我们给予我们这个仁慈。
No, because without independence, you can't love. There has to be independence for love.
因为就是在这个爱中必须要有这种。
Would you like to marry a stone, Nadia?
在爱中必须要有
No independence.
独立性一定的自由意志。你愿意去爱一个 stone 吗？
But life means independence. That's the definition of life. There has to be independence. Can't be alive if it's not independent.
生命就意味着这个独立，就是说如果没有这种独立性的话，就根本就没有没有这个生命可言，没有爱可言。
Krishna is equal to everyone, but depends how you approach him.
Krishna 呢，他是对每个人都是一视同仁的，但是呢，根据你接近他的方式的不同，他会相应的回应你。
You know, so many demons, Sishupal, they were benedicted by Krishna.
那么多的恶名。恶魔就比如说西出发了Krishna 仍然就是赐予他益处
Putana Kansa
Kansa
But you just have to worry about yourself
所以呢你需要就是担心你自己
You will get it if you want it But it'll take time
如果你想要的话，你就会得到，但是呢，是需要花一些时间。
You know, it's like you're in the first grade and you say, I want to be a physicist, I want to be a rocket scientist. And they'll say, well, it'll take 25 years. No, I want now. What can I say? You don't love me because you're not making me a rocket scientist this semester. No, it takes longer. Oh, you don't care. You can't say that.
就比如说你现在还在小学一年级这个时候呢你就说我想成为这个科学家然后呢你没有让我立马就成为这个科学家所以呢你不爱我其实这一点是说不通的这个逻辑上因为你现在就是还没有到那个程度
No. See, the problem is not that Krishna doesn't care, the problem is we don't care.
所以这个问题并不是 Krishna 不在乎我们，而是我们不在乎。
But by saying Krishna doesn't care, we're avoiding the problem, which is that we don't care.
就是我们就是拿 Krishna 不在乎我为借口，我们就逃避了我们自己不在乎这个问题本身。
And if we care, Krishna cares. I mean, he always cares.But he can't reciprocate with the caring if he has nobody to reciprocate with.
如果我们在乎的话 ，Krishna 他就会在乎。即便我们不在乎 ，Krishna 也会在乎。就是 Krishna 他会回应我们的每一个就是自己的这个愿望。
Krishna, why did you let me come to the material world?
Krishna, 你为什么要让我来到这个物质世界？
I tried to talk you out of it. You wouldn't listen to me. You wanted to come here.
我试图想要说服你不要来这儿，但是你却没有听我的，你还是来到这里了。
You read Bhagavad Gita 100 lives back, and you did nothing about it. It's not my fault.
然后呢，你就是一直不断的在就是讲《薄伽梵歌》讲了有几百次了。但是呢，就是我还在这里，就是你并没有关心我。
Love is voluntary.
所以呢，爱是自发的。
So the point is to reciprocate with that love.
所以呢，这个要点是我们应当去回应。Krishna 的这本爱
not to curse it
而不是诅咒
if you love me you wouldn't put me in this world he didn't put you in this world you put yourself
然后呢，不应该想，如果 Krishna 真的爱我的话，他不应该把我放在这个物质世界。事实上，不是 Krishna 把你放于物质世界，是你自己把自己置于物质世界。If
you love me, you wouldn't create this world. Well, where am I going to put you? You don't fit in the spiritual world. I have to put you somewhere. And if I put you in a perfect place, you won't come back. So I have to put you in a place where you can come back. From where you can come back.
就是如果你真的爱我的话，你就不会让我，就是你就不会把我置于这个物质世界，因为你已经不适合待在这个灵性世界了。所以呢，而且在物质世界，如果你处在一个完美的位置的话，就不会想着要回归家人。Just
let Krishna love you.
就好像Krishna他爱你。Don't
fight it.
就是不要跟他争辩。He
just wants us to reciprocate.
他只是想让我们去回应他的这份爱。
I have a God brother. He said something beautiful.
他说了一些非常美妙的话。
You know, Krishna is missing in our life, right? God is missing. So my God brother said, who do you think left the relationship? Whose fault is that?
那么他就说，Krishna呢，他在我们的这个生活，我们的关系当中缺失了。那么呢，你认为这是谁的错呢？ 就是Krishna没有在我们的关系当中。
We left. We messed up, and then we blame him, but we're the ones who left. It doesn't make sense.
然后呢，那么我们离开了这段关系，我们却去指责 Krishna, 那么这就是有点毫无道理。
And all these ideas that Krishna doesn't love me and this and that, it's all material conditioned ideas. It has nothing to do with Krishna consciousness. It's just all our conditioned ideas.
那么就有关键的想法，Krishna他不爱我，不在乎我，这就是一种物质的受条件限制的一些想法，这根本就不是Krishna知觉。
I was talking to a devotee, and she was saying, Krishna consciousness philosophy makes me feel shameful and guilty.
我呢，之前有跟一位奉献者在交流，然后他就跟我说，
It could make you feel that way.
它可能会让你觉得这种内疚。
But it's not the fault of the philosophy that we feel that way. It's the way we process it.
但是呢，并不是这个哲学本身的这个错误让你有这种感觉，而是。 就是你的这种看待问题的这个视角，才让你有这种感受。This
person grew up as a Christian in a small town, and there was a lot of the preaching made the congregation feel very guilty.
就是在一个小镇里面呢，有一群这个基督教徒，他们呢就是在。 进行传教的时候呢，他们会让人感觉非常的就是这种惭愧。So
naturally, she was feeling guilty. She was traumatized by her Christian upbringing.
所以呢，就是她曾经是属于这个基督徒的，不参加过他们的那个活动，所以很自然的，就是当她来到 Krishna 知觉的时候，她也会觉得。So
we have to understand that it's. If we have a problem, it's the problem in the way in which we process Krishna consciousness.
如果我们有问题的话呢，我们会觉得就是说，是，我们会以这个问题本身的一个视角来去，就是对待 Krishna 知觉。
Hmm. Nadia, can Krishna do whatever he wants? Will you allow him? Is that okay?
Nadia, 就是, 你可以就是让 Krishna...
If you allow Krishna to do whatever he wants, then you're following in the footsteps of Radharani.
就是如果你要是想去做 Krishna 想让你做的一切的话, 那么你就去, 追随, Radharani 的步伐。
You can't, if you make him happy, you can't suffer. It's not possible.
如果就是, 你让 Krishna 快乐的话, 你自己不可能受苦。
Krishna will reward you tremendously. Just be patient.
Krishna 他会就是, 以一种你不可思议的方式去回馈你。 你需要耐心。
It's like, just have faith. That's all I can say.
对呢, 我想说的就是你需要有信心。
You have some karma to work out. Just have faith.
你有一些业报就是需要去, 经历处理。
When he sees
你需要信,
you, when he sees you tolerating the difficulty, then he showers mercy on you.
当他就是看到你能够去容忍这些困难的时候，他会 给你他的仁慈。
And we have to think he has some plan, and it's good for us, even though we may not understand it at this point.
我们要 非常确信 Krishna 他对我们是有这个规划的，有计划的， 而这种计划是最终会让我们受益，对我们有好处的。 我们需要以这种方式去理解。
But if we think Krishna is causing us suffering, then definitely we'll suffer with those thoughts.
就说可能 即便目前我们并不理解 Krishna这份计划， 但是呢最终 Krishna的这个计划是 对我们有好处的。 如果我们认为是 Krishna 让我们受苦， 那么我们的这种想法就会让我们受苦。
So we have other questions?
Yes, there are many questions. 我们看下面的问题。 今天的问题好多啊。 潘立凤， Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj，就是所有奉献者。 嫉妒是因为内心的不满足和对自我的忽略造成的吗？ So Hare Krishna, obeisances to Guru Maharaj and all the devotees. Envy is because in our heart, we are not satisfied, and also we ignore ourselves.
We ignore ourselves because in our heart we're not satisfied? That's the question?
We envy. This is because in our heart we are not satisfied, and also we are ignore ourselves.
I think it's you won't be satisfied if you ignore yourself. Not that you ignore yourself because you're not satisfied. I mean, it could be both, but I think it's more that. If you don't follow a spiritual process properly, you won't be satisfied. That's a simple answer.
那么一个简单的回答呢，就是事实上，由于你忽略了自己，所以呢，你的内心会不满足。那么呢，就是如果 就是从灵性方面来说呢，如果你没有去追随这个灵修的这个程序的话呢，你的内心也会不满足。She asked that we have envy. This is also because in our heart we are not satisfied.
Envy? Also, yes.
They know ourselves.
Yes.
Shuda.
Okay, so that's the question.
Next question.
Wendy David, 敬拜 good 莲花祖, good 书中有说, 如果没有帮助对方的灵性成长, 这也是一种暴力。 那么如果看到对方的状态, 但是感觉自己无力帮助, 目前能做的就是祈祷。 除祈祷之外, 还有其他方法吗? So, obeisances to Guru Lotus Feet. In your books, you said that if we don't have others to grow spiritually, this is violence. So, I want to ask that if we know others' situation, but we know in that situation, we are self, are helpless. We could do anything to them, but we can only pray to them. So, what are there more things that we can do others besides prayer to others?
Just become more Krishna conscious. It's the best way to help others, influence others.
你就是自己变得具有更具Krishna直觉，那么你就是帮助他人的一个很好的一个方式。Prayer
and you know just become pure. That's all you can do.
你呢就是祈祷能够变得更加纯粹。嗯，这是你可以。Give
them prasadam also.
而且呢就是给他们prasadam。
You know, there has to be a certain detachment that some people are just, they're not ready for Krishna consciousness, and we just have to be detached enough to let them live their life, and they'll learn. Eventually, they'll come to Krishna at some point.
因为有些人他还没有做好准备接受Krishna直觉，所以呢，我们就给予他们充分的自由，让他们按照自己的方式去生活，可能到他们生命的某一点上，他们就会最终能够接受Krishna直觉。 That's the question.
One more.
我们再来回答一个问题，真真 Hare Krishna 亲爱的Guru队，顶拜你的莲花祖，顶拜翻译主持人，所有奉献者，请教Guru，我是个新奉献者，感受到了很多爱和仁慈，依然没有办法全然的专注，全然的把自己交付，这种感觉还会有思辨，因此会痛苦，心又在跑来跑去，这种情况怎么办？感恩Guru队。 So, Hare Krishna, obeisances to Gurudev's loaded feet. And I'm a new devotee, and I feel so much love and mercy from others. But still, I couldn't focus myself. I couldn't devote myself to the process. And sometimes I will speculating, and I will also feel the miserable because my mind is just run over here and there. So what should I do in this situation?
Eat a lot of prasadam.
荣耀更多的prasadam.
Associate with advanced devotees.
去跟那些进步的奉献的联谊。
Improve your chanting.
然后改善你的加帕。
Read more. Read more.
阅读更多的书籍，帕巴的书籍。
All of this will help you.
所有这一切会帮助到你。
Beyond that, you may have to work on your mentality. Have a more favorable mentality, more positive mentality.
嗯，除此之外呢，你还要改善你的一个心态，就是呢，啊，你应当有更多的有益于 Krishna 知觉的一个心态，积极的心态。
Takes time to improve. You have to try. Keep trying.
嗯，你需要不断的去努力，去尝试，需要花一些时间的。
Who asked that question?
珍珍。
珍珍。
Yeah. 珍珍。
Yeah. If it may be necessary that I speak to her personally, because there may be other things I don't know about.
就是如果需要的话呢，也可以找个时间啊，可以单独，来与你交流，看看你是否还有其他的一些个人的问题。
So if she wants to speak personally, she can tell you, and you can arrange it.
嗯，就如果你需要跟咕噜单独会面交流的话呢，就是你可以告诉我，或者是Lilarani，然后到时候我们为你做一些安排。
Okay, time is up.
啊，今天时间到了。
Can save the questions for next class. Okay.
Okay. 好，李兰让你把这个问题留下一次吧。
好的，好的，我存了。
好。
Thank you, good day. Thank you for.
You're welcome. Thank you all for coming.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And pay attention to what I said in this class. It's important.
今天呢要就是留意我在课中所讲的内容，对你们来说是非常有益的。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Have a good night.
大家下周见。我们好好吸收今天讲课的内容。下周日再见，Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。